Hi, my name is Tara, and on behalf of fontbundles.net, I will be showing you today how to access Samantha fonts and access the glyphs within the Samantha font family. First of all, you'll need to download the Samantha fonts yourself. So you can purchase these at fontbundles.net, and you can find that online if you just Google, and you can see that Font Bundles will come up. To find the Samantha font bundle family or individual fonts, you just need to type in Samantha into the search bar. And you can see here that Samantha font comes up as the upright, as the standard one, or you can also choose the family font. When choosing the family font, you do receive all the different formats, which will be italic, bold, the standard upright, and the bold upright. Once you have purchased these, you'll need to download them, unzip them, and install them into your computer. Once you have done that, and I'm going to get rid of that, you can go into your chosen program to use your fonts. The glyphs can be used in pretty much any program. You can go from Inkscape through to Cricut Design Space, Silhouette Studio Design, Microsoft Word, Microsoft Publisher, Photoshop, Adobe Illustrator, all those programs you can use your glyphs. Today I'm going to use the Silhouette program. And you can see here in Silhouette Design Space or Silhouette Studio, I have typed in fontbundles.net in a standard font. Now, when using character maps, apart from using Publisher, you need to have your text in the font that you are choosing to use the glyphs. So as we're using Samantha Upright today, I'm going to select my text. I'm going to go up to the text style and I'm going to select the font Samantha. And I'm going to select, if I can find it, Samantha Upright. And there we have the Samantha Upright font. Now, this font is really beautiful in itself, but one of the advantages of this particular font is that it comes with many hundreds of different types of glyphs for each letter. Now, to access these, you need to use character maps, or if you're on a Mac, you need to use your Fontbook. To find character maps, myself personally, I have, if you can see down here, I actually have it pinned to my taskbar because I use this often. And I recommend that if you're going to use glyphs and take advantage of the fonts you buy from fontbundles.net that do have glyphs, to get the app and pop it on your taskbar down the bottom, because then you've got it available to use very quickly every time you need to use a glyph. But if you don't have it down there, you just need to go to search and type in character maps. And you'll find that your PC will find it for you, and you can just click on it. And there you have character maps will pop up. And the next thing we need to do is find the font that we're using. So we're using Samantha Upright. So we just need to scroll through and find that in here. And there you go, there's Samantha Upright. And you'll see that the text of every different letter will come up for you. And you can see all the standard text. But we want to access the glyphs. So to do that, we need to ensure that the advanced view is checked. And then we can go down to group by. And in the group by, we need to drop all the way to the bottom and select Unicode subrange. Once you have selected this, a second window will pop up. And you need to scroll all the way to the bottom and select private use characters, which will now access your glyphs. And as you can see on the left here, our glyphs have now appeared, and if I scroll through, there are many for every single letter of the alphabet. But today we're going to change some of the letters on the font that the text we've just written. So I want to change the letter F to start with. So I'm going to scroll through and look for an F that I like. I think that F's quite good there. So you have two choices. You can either double click, which will bring it into your characters to copy, or you can select it and then click select, and it will also bring it into your characters to copy. Once you have the letter that you want in there, you can click copy and then click back onto your design space. Once you've done that, double click on your text and delete the letter you want to replace. And then all you have to do is press Control V on your PC and that will paste the glyph into your text. Now, if we want to change another letter, it's as simple as going back to character maps, deleting the previous character that we copied into our little characters to copy box, and finding the next letter you'd like to use. So I'm going to change the S in font bundles. So it's again scrolling through, and you have, as I said, you have hundreds to choose from. Let's find a nice letter S. Here we go, RS. So we might want to pick that one there. So select it, select, copy, go back, delete the one you want to remove, press Control V and place it in. Let's change the letter T as well. So we go back to character maps, we remove the letter that we copied, and then we find a letter T that we like. And there's plenty to choose from again. This one here's quite fancy. We'll select that, we'll copy it, go back, delete the letter we don't want, Control V, and paste it in. And as you can see, our glyphs are now clear into our text. And we can repeat that as many times as you like, because character maps will stay open and you can toggle between the character maps boxes and the design space that you're using, or Microsoft Word. And it's just a matter of remembering to delete each time the characters you've copied, so when you paste next time, you don't paste two or three glyphs at once. I hope you have enjoyed this video on how to access the glyphs in the Samantha font family. Please be sure to check out the Design School at fontbundles.net for many different tutorials in different software programs, and also check out our YouTube channel at fontbundles.net, where we have many videos showing different tutorials. Thank you.